I'd like to just start off our certificates. And every year, I think you know that we do a little bit of kind of like, let's guess what these people are like. Years before, I've gone through their personal statements and picked out quotes and said, okay, who do you think made this quote? Who do you think wrote this in their personal statement? So I thought I'd mix it up this year a little bit. So I asked the junior residents, so the PGY2s, and for those of you who are not familiar with the hierarchy here, the junior residents are basically kind of the minions for our chiefs. They're the chiefs of the boss, they tell them what to do, they mentor them, they educate them, and I said, okay, you just tell me in one word, don't think about it, just 30 seconds, tell me what the first word that comes to your mind. So I don't know what Sam means, but... So again, I asked around. I was able, luckily enough, to get some dig back into Nikhil's past, and his friend Dan Colby, who's an emergency medicine physician over at Davis, shared with me. I went to undergrad with Nikhil, and even back at UCLA, he seemed destined for orthopedics with his work as an athletic trainer. Now that he is going to return there as an ortho sports medicine fellow, he has come full circle. I also worked with him during his ortho consult year at UC Davis from the emergency medicine perspective. Despite the fact that he took call Monday through Friday from 6 till 10 for an entire year, he always had a great attitude. Oh, and I think he quickly learned that most people prefer some sort of sedation for distal femur stenosis. Nikhil. His friend Anitra, also a fellow orthopedic surgeon, pointed out a few points of admiration that he's developed for Nikhil over the years. So first, he knew orthopedics was his goal since entering medical school. He stuck to that goal and persevered even when not matching multiple times. He's one of the hardest workers I know, having completed prelim surgery rotations at Harvard UCLA and the prelim intern year at UC Davis. And is admirable because it was all to achieve one goal. Even when people around him suggested to consider other fields, he did not let that faze him. One of the happiest days of his life was when he realized he had been selected for a spot at Stanford. And the second happiest is when he's leaving Stanford. The next point of admiration that Anit points out is loyalty to his friends. He holds his family and friends to high regard and puts them as a priority in all aspects of his life. He had an afro at his undergrad as well. Dr. Bellino shared with us, I've always felt a connection with Nikhil. After all, we shared the same job before residency. We completed a year of trauma consults at UC Davis, and we were avid soccer players. The first time I met Nikhil, he struck me as a mature, calm, and composed individual. These attributes were complemented by a subtle, clever sense of humor. As it turns out, my first impression was correct. Throughout his residency, he worked extremely hard, was always prepared, and always had a plan. I had the feeling that he thought that his plan was better than mine, perhaps it was. And that is true. That is Nikhil. That sums him up. What I admire most about Nikhil is that he is a genuinely thoughtful and kind person. It pleases me that Nikhil is a representative of our program. I wish him the best of luck in his future endeavors. Dr. Yao asks, Nikhil is somewhat quiet but very competent surgeon. He occasionally seems aloof, but that shouldn't belie his commitment to his profession and achieving his goal of becoming an orthopedic surgeon. He's so committed to learning, he very recently came to a hand surgery journal club despite the fact that he'll be entering sports medicine fellowship. It could have been for the free food, but I'll give him the benefit of the doubt. Dr. Bishop asks, Nikhil really needs to be recognized for his grit. He overcame every challenge put before him and developed into a competent and confident orthopedic surgeon. He's now at the beginning of what I know will be a successful and fulfilling career. Dr. Huddleston adds, Nikhil ranks as one of our best free agent pickups. He always took great care of our patients and was known to be a pleasure to work with by both his peers and the staff. Good luck in Los Angeles. Nikhil's dad shared with me a very nice letter. He said, he replied to me, an email from Stanford requested me to share some good memories in Nikhil's life caused a storm in my brain. When sweet memories are too many, they kind of overlap each other and create a distorted picture. One day, I bought a bike for myself in a garage sale. Nikhil told me, Dad, do not worry. I'll teach you how to ride a bike. Going along with Dr. Bellino saying, Nikhil's got a plan. Let me tell you how to do this. Regarding his medical career, he wanted to be an orthopedic surgeon only. There was no plan B, nada. As a parent, we considered it as a dangerous situation. Well, we're glad that we were wrong. And so are we. Let me thank members of faculty at Stanford Orthopedics for providing him an opportunity to achieve his dream. I appreciate your efforts. Every cloud has a dark lining too. My wife, Seema, lost her battle with cancer in 2014. While recovering from surgery in 2006, she confided with me, I want to see Nikhil become a medical doctor. When he graduated from medical school, she was recovering from another surgery and doctors advised her not to travel. No way, she said. She did attend his graduation in Columbus, Ohio, even though wounds were still wet and stitches present. I can only wish that she was here to witness this graduation. Rest in peace, Seema. Your wish has come true. So here, a lot of nice things, memories come to my mind. When Nikhil joined us, I just started as program director, so he's kind of, as Dr. Huddleston said, one of our pickups from another program. We're very happy to have him. So I had the chance of transitioning him to our program, so I feel like I have a connection with him as well, although I don't get to see him very often. But this is where I wrote my letter, and I think it is very genuine, as all my letters are. Nikhil joined our program as a PGY2 after completing. It's true. Stop giggling, drink your wine, and listen to me. So this is what I wrote for Nikhil. Nikhil joined our program as a PGY2 after completing a year of internship and a year of trauma service at other institutions. I was not sure how he would adapt to the new environment and get up to speed with his classmates. However, within a year, he was on par with his peers and doing very well. This is a testament to a strong work ethic and motivation. While my service, Nikhil performed admirably. He was excellent with patient care. An example of his hard-working nature is when he came in to help me with urgent surgeries on the weekend, even though he was not on call or had any responsibility to do so. The on-call team easily could have handled this, but Nikhil was genuinely interested in learning the surgeries and was dedicated to maximizing his experience on the rotation. On a personal level, Nikhil is truly a good person. He is honest, reliable, kind to those around him, and fun to be around. So congratulations, Nikhil.
That's like the 30th time Dr. Vinian is trying to hug me and the first time I've actually let him. So, everyone who's been to my grand rounds and my disputation knows I don't really like speaking in public, so I'll make this short. I think the most impressive thing about everything that Dr. Vidian said was that Dr. Bellino actually responded to an email. In all seriousness, those of you who know me, I've been through this multiple times in terms of the match. Didn't match multiple times and finally ended up with a spot here. And I just really want to thank Dr. Maloney and Dr. Chang for giving me an opportunity because, I mean, if you guys didn't, I don't know where I would be. I just really appreciate the chance that you guys gave me, and I hope that I made you proud. And I want to thank a few of the mentors here. Everyone here, all the faculty here are great, but specifically Dr. Bellino and Dr. Bishop. You guys couldn't be more polar opposites, but both of you have taught me exactly what it means to be a professional. So thank you to both of you and Dr. Maloney and Dr. Chang, and that's it.
I'm disappointed that the audiovisual is not working today because I prepared quite a bit of coordinated types of things, but you'll have to just imagine this. But Nikhil and I go way back, actually. I met Nikhil when he was at Davis, actually, and I was a medical student there. And I very distinctly remember having lunch with him out in the courtyard. It was kind of a sunny day, and we were sitting there and talking, and I was just getting to know him. And I remember thinking to myself, man, this guy is, he's a really weird, creepy guy. Who knew that we'd both end up here at Stanford? So, as I got to know him a lot better, I realized that, he's really not that creepy, but we eventually even became roommates this year, having an opportunity to live with Nikhil has been really great. I'll skip over some of that stuff because it's not as good without visual aid. Suffice it to say that I've really gotten to see what Nikhil is about. He's a really hardworking guy. Every time I come home, he's sitting there preparing for cases or studying for boards in his usual spot, kind of in the corner of our living room there. And I think that he's been a good role model in regards to, you know, what it takes to be a successful resident and to be well regarded amongst his peers, certainly. He's never really shied away from work. You know, he even offered to take some of my calls when I was interviewing for my fellowships because he knew I was, you know, nervous about matching, and then I wanted to take all the fellowship interviews that I could. And he was great in offering that. I didn't take him up on it, but I do think that he was sincere in that. And I know that he's done the same for many of his co-residents in his class as well. And lastly, just having him around, you know, living together, has been a great resource for me. Just bouncing things off of him when I'm preparing for cases, tough cases, things that I'm on call that I'm not sure what to do. It's great to have somebody there for me and to be a friend and a mentor even. And you know, he'll be going on to UCLA. I know he went to undergrad there, and he really wanted to end up back in LA, so I'm really happy for him. And as has been outlined here already, he's worked really hard for it, and he deserves everything he gets. So wherever he ends up, I know he'll be great. So thanks to you, Nikhil. Hope to see you more in the future. So. And.
Thank you.